أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد فالسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to class number 6, where we once again will shed a light on these beautiful divine names. Everybody on the face of the earth is looking for honor and prestige. Everybody wants to be known today. It has turned into an obsession. And what we seem to be forgetting about is the true honor and the true humiliation. And we also seem to be forgetting that honoring and humiliating is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Jalla wa Ala says in the Quran, قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكِ تُؤْتِي الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتَنْزِعُ الْمُلْكَ مِمَّنْ تَشَاءُ وَتُعِزُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتُذِلُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ. In brief, and you give honor to whomsoever you want, and you dishonor whomever you want. Now, a lot of people think that dishonoring is equal to not having in your life what you want. So people say, Allah hasn't honored me. Why am I not known amongst people? Why don't I have a lot of money? Why don't I have a lot of followers? Why don't I have a lot of likes? Why? And very often people seem to be thinking that this is the scale on which they need to weigh honor. But when we are going to look at the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described it in his book, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his sunnah, then you see that the honor and the true honor is in harmony with the strength of your belief and the strength of your faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the distance between you and the anger of Allah, and the distance between you and haram. So if you want to know whether Allah is humiliating you or whether Allah is honoring you, then look at what you are doing. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wouldn't allow the one whom he is honoring to dishonor himself through haram. So Allah Jalla wa Ala, on the other hand as well, when you look at it, you should know that you will not know what honor truly means until you are dishonored. You will not know the value of health unless you are sick, and the value of wealth unless you are poor, and the value of a cheer unless you know what a fear means, or a tear. So when we are going to look at this, barakallahu fikum, you shouldn't think that being humiliated now by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is found in that which people consider to be a humiliation. It is rather that which Allah considers to be a humiliation, that which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam considers to be a humiliation. And the closer to Allah, the more you are honored, even if the entire humanity would dishonor you, even if all the world would dishonor you, humiliate you, think evil of you, but you would have Allah Jalla wa Ala as the one believing in you, as the one knowing that you are someone who has to be honored, then he will do so. And maybe not in this life. Sometimes you need to wait. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he wants good for someone, he lets him wait. He waits and he waits and he waits and he waits for the solution to the problem, for the door to be opened, to open that door and to find ease and peace. But Salman al-Farisi said, like Ibn Ajiba rahimahullah, mentioned in Iqad al-Himam, that sometimes someone may ask Allah for something, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives it immediately. While Allah doesn't like the person, he says, give that servant what he is asking for because I dislike his voice. It's an arrogant voice. It's a complaining voice. It's a gossiping voice. It's a slandering voice. It's a treacherous voice. And then this person who is asking Allah and receives immediately what he has been asking Allah, he thinks, I am special, Allah is honoring me because I ask him and he gives me. Exactly like a spoiled child. When parents are walking through Tesco's or Lidl or Aldi and it starts crying for a chewing gum, and then they just give it so because they want it to keep its mouth shut. Not because they like what he or she is doing, but rather like, don't embarrass me, here, have it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sometimes doesn't like someone, say, give him. I don't want to hear his voice. And he says, and this person then thinks Allah is honoring me. Al-Mu'izz subhanahu wa ta'ala. But then on the other hand, you might have this pious person who is on the path of Allah Jalla wa Ala, who is on the Sirat al-Mustaqim, who tries to hold on to that which Allah has prescribed, to that which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said. And he asks Allah and Allah doesn't give him. And then he says, Al-Muthil. Yani the one who dishonors and humiliates Yani is the one who has humiliated me. And I do not blame my Lord. It's probably because I'm a bad person. But this person doesn't know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told these angels, do not give my servant what he is asking for, because I love his voice. It is a true voice. It is a sincere voice. And although that I did not give him or her what they were asking for, nevertheless they kept on begging and asking, because they know that I'm the giver, that I'm the bestower, that I possess everything which is in the heavens and on the face of the earth and beyond. So this person then looks at himself and says, I don't think Allah loves me. I don't think that otherwise he would have honored me. The honor is Yawmul Qiyamah. When all the people who thought evil of you, when all the people who thought you were a loser and nothing, that you were worthless, they look at you when you are being given that status by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that level in paradise that they will be longing for, that they desire, that they dream of, that they want. And they will say, oh, we were wrong about that person. Yes, you were. The real true honor is all in the verse where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازْ وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ. And the one who escapes from hellfire and being entered to paradise, yani he is the true, yani prosperer, yani he's the one who truly prospered. So in very brief, al-izz and al-dhul, yani the honor, like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Izzul mu'min istighna'uhu 'anil nas. The honor of the mu'min is that he is not in need of the people. Wa sharafuhu, and his honor is qiyamuhu bil-layl, is that he prays during the night. So your izz is that you are not in need of people emotionally. You are not dependent on people. You are dependent on Allah. So that is your izz. And your status and your honor is in night prayer, when everybody sleeps, and that you just, you know, wake up, put on your beautiful garments, and you perfume yourself, and you go down on your knees begging him, please, and you repent, and you share with him the true love you feel for him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the more you honor your deen, and the more you honor your Lord, and the more you honor your Prophet, the more that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will honor you. Wa salli lahumma wa sallim wa baraka ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.